see you.
Good. It's George Kappler. He's over there.
George, nice to meet you.
It's an honor.
Well, nice to see you and have you. Congratulations, a little belated for that done in 1984.
Well, thank you very much.
He had a gallstone operation and delayed. He couldn't be here at the time.
Well, I understand, though, that you've proven they chose well with what the business has done in the last
year. Oh, yes. We continue to grow.
Well, that's great. Listen, why don't we get him in the middle and...
All right, sir.
Here, let me hold your badge.
Thank you.
Okay.
Very good.
Okay, good.
Well, glad to see you again, Ben.
I understand also you were elected to be one of the delegates to the Small Business Conference.
Yes, sir. I came up in August and had a very enjoyable time.
Well, that's great. You're in good company.
Yeah.
trust that y'all will listen to some of our recommendations.
I told you three-legged chicken story today to some farmers. You remember your three-legged chicken story about the cheetah running by and keeping
it? Yes.
Didn't give you credit to have a bad. You people tell stories that make you keep going. That was a good story you told me about, you know, the chicken. It was random and song with the evil of the car, and they said like drumsticks all over. That was a good story.
I'm trying to drum up all the Irish ones for tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. I got to make the Irish. Hibernia Society in Charleston, South Carolina. So I'm going to go down. I'm trying to get my Irish poetry up.
I've got a great speech for either one of you here. I mean, a great story, you know, like you like to say, I'll start out a speech with something that indicates you're not going to talk for an hour and a half and so forth. Well, this story was told by the Israeli ambassador here. You just simply get up and you say, as Henry VIII said to each of his six wives, I won't keep you long.
All right.
Well, good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you.
You're awfully nice to do this.
Well, this is Lynda
President, sir.
Hello.
Pleasure to meet you.
Great pleasure to meet you.
And this is Michael family. This is Steve. This is Joe.
Good to meet you, sir.
And Steve.
It's a great honor, sir.
And Mrs. Michael, the mother of...
Very honored to meet you, President.
Great honor, President.
Michael. And this is
Phil Schaefer, you
know. Phil Schaefer, who runs the teenage pageant.
Thank you for everything you're doing for us.
On behalf of Arrive Alive, an organization fighting drunk driving for teenagers, I brought you a representative t-shirt.
Well, thank you for wearing it.
I will show this off to my wife.
All right. It's a most worthy cause for the teenagers of America.
Well, I'm very pleased about that. And I also understand that we can say happy birthday to you.
Thank you, sir.
I reached the ripe old age of 17.
Yes, I'm getting over the hill now.
That's cute.
Well, why don't we do a family photo?
Yes, I certainly
have you all somehow together on the side of the mountain.
Be surrounded.
Why don't you come over here and
we're all in.
I'll tell you, can we have one with just the
sure.
Two?
Okay.
Just step out there right. One second, and then...
Then I'll take one.
Yeah, sure. And then why don't you come in? You want to come in?
Yes.
Come on.
All right.
Come right in. Runs the pageant.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. President. And it's a little bit heavy, but this is for your work in Gallipolis,
locked on the Ohio River, and it is something that is one of the oldest locks and dams on the Ohio River. And due to your effort, your pushing, you were able to get the funds in order to start construction on a new, and the contract will be let this year.
Well, I am delighted to know that. I was on the road campaigning, and that's the whistle that they use for...
That is the original whistle that on the lock and dam that was mounted there in 1937.
Well, for heaven's sake.
So...
Well, I was pleased to do it, and I think it's a worthwhile project.
Well, you did a good job. And you're doing a mighty good job right now in everything that you're doing. Yeah. Phil, would you care? I have a picture, Mr. President, if you could and would autograph it.
I'd be very pleased to.
Okay, fine.
Yeah. I know I owe you a thanks for a vote just recently.
Oh, we were with you. We were with you. This is my daughter, and I have a card, and it is Jackie Williams.
Hmm. That's a rhino.
Maybe we need something harder.
No, this will work.
Well, that's not necessary. I have another one lying in my office.
Oh, right.
Yes. I like your sign, it can be done. I have one that says, don't bring me problems, bring me solutions.
Well, there.
That's wonderful.
Sorry, I forgot that. Got you both in there, but now you'll have to give it to her.
I will indeed. My wife passed away,
I know.
And you know, sent us a sympathy card, letter, and I'm very grateful for that. She thought you were great.
Bless you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm a veteran of Vietnam. I wanted to thank you much. I appreciate your comments on behalf of Vietnam, on behalf of all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for everything you're doing, and keep up the good work. We need you.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
So, Conte,
yes, Mr. President. Hi, how are you?
Good to see you, Mr. President.
Looking right. Now. Pretty soon we'll put that down.
Another week or so.
Yeah. Having been there now.
You're lucky.
Oh, I did.
This is
really
bad.
That's
all I thought.
Nice
to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you for bothering us some time.
President of Stonehill College, and we got this bill through Mr. President for a library for Joe Martin, who you know very well.
Yes.
And Joe King, representative.
He's our congressman.
And it's going to be a jury.
He's the last Republican speaker, and the only one for whom nothing had been done. So through Mr. Conte's good graces,
yes,
we're able to honor his memory because it was very special to our area, to the whole state.
Well, I'm very pleased to add my name.
Well, we appreciate it.
We have two
copies of the bill, if you wouldn't mind autographing.
Right.
I sit with the Father MacPhaidin and the President Reagan and old Conte here.
And you'd say, Patrick, had something
that's
to
right.
do with this. Just sign them down here.
Sure, that'd
yes,
be fine.
Please.
One from the library.
I'm getting my Irish stories all ready for tomorrow.
I'm going to see up in the hill, God willing, and get out of bed. And...
Mr. President, there's a third one here, Mr. Conte. Did you mean that to be signed as well?
All right.
Right.
Mr. President, I have to tell you, I'm the only Irish-born president in the United States of any college or university. I appreciate this very much as a St. Patrick's Day gift.
Well, well, I'm going to say
thank you very much. I'm an immigrant in 1954, and we're the youngest in the chain of the Holy Cross Family School, founded by the Baylor University in 1948. So we're the baby in the chain. We're doing well. With this splendid gift from Congressman, Speaker Martin, and through the good graces of Congressman Conte, we forge ahead. And I'd like to say thanks on behalf of all the students, faculty, and everyone to you.
Well, I take it this donor would come under the category of a small college.
Yeah, about 1,800 liberal arts.
That was a big college compared to the one I was going to. But I'm a believer in that level of education.
Yeah. I think we may see each other tomorrow at the ambassador's reception, Mr. President.
I'll be there, yes.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you again, Mr. President. Really appreciate it. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Barbara Lent.
Hello there.
Pictures with you separately, but none together.
So well, that's
really,
turn it
really
down.
A pleasure.
This is going to be terrific. Very much. Going to help you everywhere we can down here on the hill, Mr. President.
No,
you're on the,
you've already
on the right track. You're on the right track. We appreciate it. You're doing a wonderful job.
Glad to see you. Ken Duberstein come back. Everyone thinks he's
here. Well, he's a new one.
That's right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
You too.
Mr. President, County President, how are you, sir?
Hi, how are you? Just fine, thank you. I'd like to introduce my family to you. This is Ashley Roberts.
Hello, Ashley.
Who is the president of her school, wants to give you some cookies or some candy, sir.
Well, thank you very much. Most grateful. One president to another.
She got 77% of the vote, Mr. President. She did pretty good. And this is Ann Wesley. This is Ann Wesley Roberts. And this is my son, David.
David?
Hi, President Reagan. How are you? It's a pleasure to see you.
My wife, Frankie.
Frankie, I know. Why don't we come in and, Frankie, why don't you get in the middle? And I know you two maybe kind of get in front of this town over here, my side. There.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Well, okay. Thank you so much, Mr. President.
It's a handsome looking family here.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
I know, speaking to all of you, of course, fellows like him and me and what I do, I kind of give the family a bad time sometimes.
But we're really proud of you. We really are. We really support you. We want you to know that.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you, Madam President.
Okay, thank you, Mr. President.
Good to see you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Well,
should be, of course.
Should be.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
I've been talking to see you all day.
Good.
Hey, somebody ought to air you.
There's no telling how we might use that picture.
Well, listen, glad you could come up, and I'm hoping that we can have your continued support as we go further with regard to our Central American friends.
Well, I'm going to support the conference this time, but there's one thing I would like to ask, that you sometime assemble a meeting, and I asked this of Schultz in a foreign relations committee, and he didn't, of all the bishops of the country, have a conference, because out in my part of the country, the people who give me the hardest time for my support of the conference, and I voted 27 times for that in one fashion or another. But it's the religious leaders, the bishops and the priests and the ministers, and they fly to Minneapolis and they take a plane down to Nicaragua, and they come back and they're indoctrinated. And I have asked Schultz, I can't get any action, but to invite them all in, however, bishops, now they wouldn't cause a disturbance. You know, you talk to them for an hour, and Schultz talks to them for an hour, and there's an effort made.